In this topic, we're going to discuss storage queue message management. We talked a little bit about this in some other topics, but the idea of being able to decouple long-running applications or back-end processing jobs using something like a queue is paramount to make sure that we can run our applications at scale in the cloud. So one of the things is we have different queuing mechanisms that we can use, and the one that we're going to discuss here is the storage queues. So we have storage queues and service bus queues. And in the storage queues, we're basically leveraging the same storage engine that we have with Azure Blob Storage. So if we took a look at a diagram here, we can basically, let's go back to our example here. We have a website here that's going to be uploading some data that we need to do some processing with. So we have our app running here on a server in Azure. And we'll go ahead and create a queue over here, a storage queue. Now, in the storage queue, it's basically going to house messages. And so this app is going to go ahead and inject messages into here, and then we're going to have some process over here that's going to be listening to that queue and doing some processing on those messages. Now, the specifics of how this processing happens is what we want to get into detail here. So let's clear our screen here. And what we want to show is a detailed look inside that queue. So if we had a message sitting in there, let's go ahead and put two messages in there. And then we have our, we'll go ahead and create two workers over here. It's going to be reading from that. So again, these are just loops that are reading into the same queue. Now the first operation that needs to happen is inside our loop, so inside of one of these, we're actually going to call get message. Right? So we'll just say get here, but we're going to call get message. Now we can tell it we want to take a bunch at a time. So we could say I want to take multiple messages and consume them. Or we could just say I want to take a single message, like the next message that's in there. Now the important thing that happens here when we call get, if we call this specific method get, what's going to happen is he's going to say, okay, I want to grab this message right now. Let's say we're grabbing a single message. When he says I'm going to grab that message, it's going to go ahead and update basically a TTL there to say, like, I've got a hold of this, so make it invisible now for X amount of time. So for argument's sake, let's say it's 5 minutes. So if we said, okay, so I want to go ahead and lock that to 5 minutes, I'm going to keep this message. That's basically saying I'm leasing this message. I'm going to go ahead and lock and lease this message. This guy is going to be responsible for it. If he crashes, let's say he's in the middle of processing this message and it takes seconds or minutes to process and he crashes for some reason, and after 5 minutes that time expires, this guy goes back into queue. So basically we flip that flag and make him available for, say, this guy to go ahead and pick up. So in that model, basically what we're allowing us to do is provide this kind of leasing mechanism in order to handle these kind of exceptions. We talked about transient fault handling in another topic, and this is really one of the premise or one of the implementations of this is to be able to say, how do we handle these faults that are going to happen in this environment? Now, you might say, well, that's great, but what if we just wanted to see how many messages were in there, or we don't want to put a lease on it? In that model, so maybe we just want to take, we have one worker down here who wants to say how many messages are in the queue. That's a common thing. We might have a management tool wrapped around this to say how big is our queue right now in order for us to autoscale or maybe make it bigger. And so when this guy comes in, he can call what's called peak. So when you call peak message, you're basically saying, let me go in and I can even examine individual messages. So I could grab this message and look at the details of him or look at the queue in general. But when I call peak, I'm saying, don't put a lease on it. I'm okay if somebody else goes ahead and grabs this message underneath me. I just want to take a look at what's going on in there or what this message particularly has in there. Now, the important point is when you have this lease, what's happening is there's actually like a big hash that gets injected back in there. Into your message. So one of the properties of it is a hash. So we have a property inside of our message that specifically just says this hash whenever we do the lease, and that's specific to the lease. So if we said, okay, it's been 4.5 minutes over here, and we're still processing this message, we can actually update the message and say, we need more time. Go ahead and up that to 5 again, we need more time. And that would be called update. So that's another command that we can use there. So when we're updating the message, we'll rebuild that property, that hash property, and we'll say, okay, we need 5 more minutes. And that can go on perpetually if we need to keep going with that. But the point is that if we don't update that, if he doesn't see anything in a certain amount of time, this queue, then he can go ahead and get rid of that. And so when this property gets updated, then the queue knows that we don't need to go ahead and delete this message or anything. We're just going to go ahead and let it be consumed by that process or used by that process, and the lease will be respected. So the point is, make sure you understand these different commands that you can run here. So we do a get message, an update, or a peek. The delete will respect that property that's associated with it.
So Cale, I'm just curious, and seeing this, it's very interesting how this works, but could you kind of give me a real-world example of how you've used that?
Yeah, so when customers are using this, these queuing mechanisms to do back-end processing, yeah, I'll give you the canonical example is images. So somebody wants to upload, let's say, profile images for a website. When people upload those images, typically we don't put really tight constraints around what size images those are. So when they come, they might bring a huge image, they might bring a really small one, and we might need to scale it for our site so it looks good on our site. Okay. And so what we would do is basically allow them to upload that image. We would inject a message into the storage queue and say, here's the path to this image in blob storage. Go make a thumbnail out of this at these dimensions. And so it can do that image processing for us and do that on the fly for us. So that's a really like the canonical example when we would use this.
That's a pretty cool example. I think I might just use that next time with my customer.
So that concludes the topic on storage queue message management in Azure.